gland will secrete the T3, T4 or the calcitonin. Okay. This one, the FSH or the follicular stimulating hormone. This FSH will is the reproductive hormone. It will stimulate the gonads. In case of the female, this FSH is responsible for the follicular development of the follicular development in the females. It is responsible for the follicular development. This luteinizing hormone, this is the luteinizing hormone, and in case of the male, it is also called as ICSH, interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Okay, this LH or the luteinizing hormone is responsible for the at the 14th day of menstrual cycle. It is responsible for the ovulation. And this period is called as an LH surge. This is adenocorticotropic hormone. The sixth one is the adenocorticotropic hormone. This adenocorticotropic hormone will target towards the adrenal gland. And this adrenal gland is responsible, it will stimulate the adrenal gland's cortex, and it is responsible for the mineralocorticoids, sex corticoids and etc., which we will discuss later in this section of the videos. The seventh one is a gonadotropic hormone, and it will target towards the gonads of the human body. Now we will discuss about the hormones which are secreted from the neurohypophysis. We actually discussed that if the neurohypophysis is a part of the hypothalamus, so the hormones which are at the neurohypophysis will actually not develop at the level of neurohypophysis. It will develop at the level of hypothalamus. So the hormones of the neurohypophysis now. So these hormones from the neurohypophysis will develop at the level of hypothalamus. And they will store there. Okay, when there is a urge of that hormone, this stored hormones at the level of hypothalamus will go towards the neurohypophysis through a hypophyseal portal system. Okay, now the neurohypophysis is having two types of hormones are there. The first one is called as an pitocin, and the next one is called pitresin. The other name of the pitocin is oxytocin. This pitocin is vasopressin. Or ADH. Anti-diuretic hormone. Or the other name is a vasopressin. Okay, these are the two hormones which will secrete at the level of the neurohypophysis, pitocin and the pitocin. Actually, at the hypothalamus level, the two types of nuclei are present. The two types of nuclei of the hypothalamus which is responsible to secrete these hormones, which are the pitocin and pitresin. The first one is the supraoptic nuclei. And the next one is the paraventricular nuclei. Paraventricular nuclei. Okay. This supraoptic nuclei is responsible to secrete pitocin, and this paraventricular nuclei is responsible for the secretion of pitocin from the neurohypophysis. So this supraoptic nuclei is responsible for the release of oxytocin. Okay, oxytocin, this we have to remember. And this paraventricular nuclei is responsible to for the secretion of the ADH or vasopressin. So we covered all the hormones from the adenohypophysis and the neurohypophysis. So that's all for today's part of the video. I hope you like the cover of mine. If do so, please like, share and subscribe my channel, because guys, this is the only way to make my knowledge reach to you.